On 8th March 2020, just before the world was halted due to the outbreak of COVID-19 virus, the Melbourne cricket ground was packed with cricket lovers. On International Women's Day, Australia played against India in the finals of the ICC Women's T20 World Cup in front of a record 86,000 people. It seemed like the 21st century had finally woken up to the presence of women playing cricket. But at every level, the game had suffered from neglect from the very start. Very few might know it, but women's cricket has been played for just as long as men's. It all began on village greens in England in the 18th century. The first recorded match was played in 1745 between the women of two Surrey villages in England, that is Bramley and Hambledon, with the teams distinguished by the colour of their hair ribbons. In 1887, one of the first women's club, the White Heather Club, was formed by ladies of Yorkshire aristocracy. 3 years later, a team known as the Original English Lady Cricketers toured England playing in exhibition matches to large crowds. The team was highly successful until its manager absconded with the profits, forcing the ladies to disband. Couple of decades later, the First World War strengthened women in a number of ways, and sports was one of them. Like several other women's sporting organizations, which were formed in post-war England, the Women's Cricket Association was formed in 1926. Then the first Women's Cricket Association outside of Britain was formed in 1931, that is the Australian Women's Cricket Association. These were two historical moments in the development of women's cricket. In 1933, the England team first played against the rest at Leicester and undertook their first international tour to Australia in 1934-35, playing the first women's test match between England and Australia in December 1934. Soon the women's game started to spread in the colonies, and the need for an international body to systematize this rapid growth became evident. In 1958, the International Women's Cricket Council was formed to coordinate women's cricket, which was now being played regularly in Australia, England, New Zealand, South Africa, the West Indies, Denmark, and the Netherlands. All these nations, along with a few more, started to play test match cricket. From test cricket, the women's game transitioned smoothly to one-day international cricket. In fact, the first Women's Cricket World Cup was played in 1973, 2 years prior to the first Men's World Cup. The World Cup was organized by English millionaire businessman Jack Hayward, who got the idea from then England captain Rachel Hayhoe Flint. Back then in the 70s, Hayward stumped up to £40,000 to cover the costs and 7 teams. That is England youth team, Australia, New Zealand, Jamaica, Trinidad and Tobago, and an international 11 made up of players from all participating countries. The same year, Women's Cricket Association of India was formed. The Indian women's team played their first test match in 1976 against the West Indies. The lack of money and resources in women's game had always been a barrier. So in the 1990s, a closer relationship was sought with the men's team. And in 1992, New Zealand became the first test playing nation to merge its men's and women's cricketing setups. In 2005, the International Women's Cricket Council agreed to hand over the control of the global women's game to the male-run International Cricket Council, that is ICC. The rise of T20 not only broadened the horizons of the men's game, it also had a significant effect on the women's game too. In 2009, the ICC staged the first ever women's T20 World Cup in England at the same time as the men's tournament. The semi-finals and the finals were double headers, with the women's matches directly before the men's, which helped the women's team secure bigger crowds and more media coverage. For its entire history, the women's game had been an amateur pursuit, played simply for love of the game. But linking up with men allowed more money to flow into the women's cricket system. In May 2014, the England Cricket Board made history by introducing the first professional contracts for women, awarding these to 18 of England's top players. There are now professional contracts in place in all T20 World Cup competing nations. 2015 was a breakthrough year for women's cricket, as the Women's Big Bash League replaced Australia's domestic T20 tournament, and thus the first franchise women's cricket tournament was created. Over time, the profile of women's cricket grew so much it no longer needed to rely on the men. The 2018 World T20 in the Caribbean was the first to be staged as a standalone tournament. That same year, India also started its own Women's T20 Challenge during IPL. It was dubbed as Women's IPL. With time, the women's game has grown significantly, but it still has a long, long way to go. Check our other whiteboard style cricket videos backed by deep research. Kindly subscribe to our channel and help us grow. Thank you.